Hello. In this lesson, we're going to learn all about campaign site progress bars. Progress bars are simple, but possibly the most important tool of a campaign site because they enable your supporters to collectively work towards one goal and stay updated. Progress bars can be added to pages that have goals, which include your campaign site homepage, your fundraiser pages, and your team pages. The homepage default template will contain a progress bar combined with a banner at the top. We can also remove this section if we have a different design in mind, and then add another progress bar section anywhere on our page. To add a new progress bar, click the plus sign to open the section library and select Fundraising. Here, we can see a few sections with progress bars that can be added to our page. Okay, now that we know how to add progress bars, let's learn about how to edit them. A progress bar on your homepage will use your campaign goal as the progress bar goal amount. You can set your campaign goal from your site's universal settings in the top bar. It's good to know that the progress bar in your site editor may not reflect your actual campaign goal or progress. This is just a preview of your design. Your live site will display your actual goal and progress. Progress bars work like any other section. For example, we can edit the color theme settings for the background and for the progress bar card. We can also click in to edit the details of the progress bar. When editing a progress bar, you can configure which items you want to display in the layout. The progress bar, total raised, and goal amount will always be displayed, but you can choose to show or hide several other items. Donations will show or hide the count of donors. Impact will display the impact tracker, which we'll cover in just a moment. You can also add up to two buttons in your progress bar. Next, in the General tab, we can configure the progress bar's impact tracker. This is an optional counter that can help supporters understand how funds raised will impact a specific program. For example, if you're planting trees and it costs $5 to plant a tree, you can enter $5 in the per project cost field, and in the project description, we might add trees planted. Now, we can see a new counter that displays the real-time impact of our campaign based on the amount we've raised. All right, before we move on, it's good to know that buttons in your progress bar will function like any other buttons on your site. You can change the button style, text, the button type, either launch a donation form, link to the fundraiser signup page, or link to an external URL. Great. Now we know how progress bars will function on our homepage. Let's take a quick peek at the fundraiser page template to learn more. We can access our fundraiser page template from the page selector in the site editor top bar. This is our fundraiser page template. It's where we can configure the design and layout of our individual fundraiser pages. The default progress bar on a fundraiser's page is not editable. This area displays content that the fundraiser enters, including their name, page title, appeal text, and profile image. The progress bar here will reflect the fundraiser's personal goal amount. Although this progress bar cannot be individually edited, you can configure the section color, although in most cases we recommend leaving this area with a white background. And quickly, if we jump to our team page template, we'll see that the progress bar on the team page will function similar to the progress bar on the fundraisers page. All right, that's how to edit progress bars on your campaign site. Now let's learn how donations on your site will be assigned to these different progress bars. In the simplest case, let's say a single page campaign site that does not have peer-to-peer activated. A donation to that page will count towards the page goal and appear in the page's progress bar. And remember, the total goal amount for this progress bar is defined in the campaign site universal settings. As a side note, donations that count towards a page's progress bar will also appear in that page's recent donation feed, which is another section that can be added to the page. Okay, so now let's say that we have peer-to-peer activated on a campaign site. It's a bit more complex, but very logical. Peer-to-peer page goals follow a hierarchy. So a donation to an individual fundraiser's page will be applied to the fundraiser's progress bar, and will roll up to the fundraiser's team progress bar if the fundraiser is on a team, and to the campaign site's homepage progress bar. That's because we're all working together. A donation to any fundraiser's page will always roll up and count towards the overall campaign goal. Okay, we'll spend just a moment more to learn about how you can add a donation to a specific page goal. This is a pretty common task for peer-to-peer campaigns. Let's say you have a donor who sends in a check, but would like their donation to be applied to a specific fundraiser's page. Great! When you create the transaction from the transaction section, you can select a page goal. Here, you can search and select the appropriate page that this donation should be applied to. Now, this donation will count towards the fundraiser's progress bar, their team's progress bar if the fundraiser is on a team, and of course, the campaign site's homepage progress bar. You can also edit the page goal settings for an existing transaction. All right, now you're an expert on fundraiser's progress bars. Have fun.